Welcome back to the world of Cradle, everybody. It has been quite a long time since we were here.
Still pretty as the ever.
But if you don't quite remember where we left off, well, Ida was going slightly insane. She's losing her ability to communicate, as our little task lets us remember. We need to go back to the pavilion, and probably do another one of those stupid cube games. So that's gonna be fun. Yuck. Hopefully we're not gonna... I'm trying to see if I can do some 1080 recording. Seems a little choppy though. Hopefully I'll be able to keep that up, because I'd love for you guys to enjoy just how pretty this game can be. Alright, so Pavilion 6. That's where we need to go. Is the fence? Wait, did I leave the, yes I did. Woohoo! I almost forgot about that thing. Makes my life that much easier so I don't have to walk all the way. Whoop! Oopsie-daisy. Is that Ungots? Do I hear you, buddy? I hear you. Alright. Sit down. Oh, wait. Whoa. Wrong button. Alright. On. And all the way over. Forward! Once more into the pavilion.
Cabera Garden.
So, we also found out quite a bit of stuff about the therapy for the children so that they didn't all explode and everything. Oh. I think I need to press this again. Yeah, there we go. Hence all the cube games. Since, you know, everything's all based off emotion. Alright. We're looking for 6. There's 10. 1, 2. Okay, so 6 is gonna be over here somewhere. There it is. I see it. Go, quickly. Suck. What crap am I gonna get up to 6? And the slide's broken. How did I get down from 6? This wasn't in the brochure. Alright, so how the crap do I get up there then? There's no building underneath it. There's no floaty device. I can't use the elevator. Are you still belching? Yeah, you are. Okay. 4, 5, 6. Can I hop up the slide? No. No, I cannot. Alright, let's take a look around. Maybe I can replace the part needed for the elevator to actually function? Oh!
I figured out what kind of breakdown the report was referring to.
Uh-huh.
During a transfer, the ability to speak was not blocked out for one of the kids. That is, he was talking to himself, to his own copy.
Well, that's creepy. I guess if you you end up talking to a copy of yourself, that would make you go slightly insane. Alright. Let's take a look at the platform a little bit. I honestly have no idea how we're supposed to get up there, though. Unless Ungots has some sort of special ability to carry me up there. Alright. We could possibly use one of the neighboring... Alright. Since this one's working, let's head up through here. Maybe there's like a bar that I can walk across? No. At least this will give us a better view of how exactly... Oh, dear. Man. I know it's just a game, but my stomach lurches every time I'm up here. Ooh-wee. Just need to observe. Oh! Maybe. Okay, if I go out here and go out and around the outer beams, could I get over there? No, I don't think so. I think I just end up screwing myself. Oh no! Alright. Alright, so I was looking back around. I realized I did kind of miss this. So we're gonna have to do some hardcore parkour. To hopefully make our way over to Pavilion 6. Oh, crap. Oh, please no. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Ah, crap. I still have to parkour while I'm over here. Oh, this is gonna suck. Yeah. Oh, great. Nothing like some creaking. Whew. Creaking bits. I see you.
Go on.
Alrighty. Open up. Open sesame. There we go. Alright, why am I sliding? Come on, hurry it up. I know. Don't have all day. One, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes! Ah, oh, first try! Booyakasha! Oh! That is satisfying slash frustrating. Got the voice part that we need. Hopefully she can stop going crazy. Alright, we got the synchronizer. Installing. No problem. Can I not, Really doesn't matter. I mean, we got. Just actually means we can move faster. Get back to our new little play pal. Whee! Looks like night
is
falling.
I know why there was so little information about me.
Hmm?
August 15th was my first workday at the Gruvera Garden. I had come
about bad luck
with that group of kids, and the explosion occurred 2 hours later.
I thought I heard one of those floaty pool dudes. I don't know. Alright. Oh, maybe not. Alright, let's go ahead and stop here. And make our way back. Now, this will be our fourth hour of Cradle. So far it's mainly kind of just been figuring out who she is, figuring out the information about the gardens and everything, and kind of learning about embodies. So I'm starting to wonder if this will be the extent to the story, or if we'll get
did
to do a bit more. Yes.
Hold on while I replace it.
Do I have to take this off again? Okay. Hold on one second. Whoops! Sorry about that. Alright, where's the synchronizer? Alright, so that's the bad synchronizer. Here's the good one. And slap this back on. Should we have, like, shut her down properly before- Oh, the seizures are back. You okay?
Well?
Yeah.
It's fine.
Thoughts still messed up?
No.
Then it helped.
She's a woman. Saying fine doesn't mean anything.
How long will your charge last?
About 2 weeks, maybe less. Say, know what I found? The correspondence of that operator, Mark, with one of his colleagues. There are some strange tidbits.
To be honest, it doesn't really interest me.
Wait, this is important. It's about your parents.
Whoa.
What?
Oh, here we go. Got some traction, finally.
And me as well. Here, listen. It's a work correspondence. They're talking about research into memory transfer between people, using telepathy.
Telepathy?
That's what it says here. They're discussing telepathy and also mention some kind of side effect. They refer to it as MPR-0.
What is it?
Well, if my understanding is correct, it's a sensation. A strange sensation experienced when one transmits...
And what of it?
Mark writes that at one time he was very interested in the matter, studying MPR-0 thoroughly after that incident with Ida.
That incident?
We must have been acquainted. Even though I remember nothing about Mark or any unusual effects, and I cannot imagine what incident he's referring to.
And what about my parents?
That's here too. He recalls working at a research station before the garden was constructed. There weren't many people around in those days. His circle of contacts was limited to several work colleagues and his Mongolian friends. He writes, it's the family living in a yurt not far from the landing platform.
Sounds like it.
Where are your parents now?
They died long ago. Why?
They could have probably answered many of our questions. Maybe Mark even told them about me.
Are you all right?
Yes, maybe. Maybe he told
them. You're freaking out again. Good grief.
Ida, is everything fine?
Everything fine is an ordinary word. Just a note.
Huh.
Like the weather,
great.
Chilly or warm, but we were looking for other research. Family records, kind letters, so... What was that just now? More of the same?
Yes. Again.
Enibish.
Right.
What?
What?
I don't think I have much time. Please, help me untangle this web with Mark. I want you to look through your parents' things. They may have left behind notes, journals.
Understood. I will go look for them. Tabaha is here.
Tabaha! Maybe he can answer some of our questions. But if we're gonna go rummaging through our crap, let me see, only parents might know what's connected, Ida and Mark. Find their personal belongings, question Tabaha. Alright. So, with Tabaha here, that's probably going to be the likeliest route. There's nothing in there anyways. Shut for many years. That doesn't mean there won't be anything. Alright, I get it. Oh, maybe there's something in here. Grandpa Butchins died. All right. Well, that didn't really get us much, and I really hate that noise, so I'm gonna go talk to Tabaha first. We'll get his input, and then we'll go rooting through our parent stuff. Because if that thing's gonna constantly ring like that, I don't know why. It's like nails on a chalkboard to me. What? What do you want?
Looks like it'll rain.
Rain? Today?
There'll be rain and thunder, and it'll sweep all profiteers into a ditch.
What happened?
You got any idea how much the search cost me?
No. How much?
One and a half.
Is that a lot?
Well, when in Biohungor has the internet ever cost 1.5?
I'll pay you back.
I won't take money from your destitute self.
All right, thanks.
The information was paid for and delivered by a personal courier.
Very nice. So, what did you find out?
Well, first of all, the Gebera Garden was never about entertainment.
It was a hospital, I know. But what happened to it?
The kids were all patients, yeah? Well, one of them had his container overflowed. The passim exploded.
That's all?
Hold your horses. The story ain't so simple. Think. A person gets his body replaced and blows up minutes later. You might ask, how could they not have checked the container? Turns out they did check, and the container was empty. And yet, 15 minutes later, it up and explodes. In other words, the capsule filled and overflowed rapidly.
There must have been a reason.
Must have been, sure. But it wasn't found. All that's known is that there was a mishap with this particular child's transfer. Turns out, he had been talking to himself while in the booth. That was the mishap. As to why he blew up, that part's unclear. When he came outside, all his stats were normal.
What's the video you mentioned?
From the security cameras. You can see everything. Here he is, coming out of the booth in an M-body. Here's the sword acceptance ceremony. Here he is, getting off the stage and heading into the garden. He's walking evenly, takes a seat on the edge of a flower.
What's happening?
A child comes up to him as he's sitting. A teeny little thing. Walks up and says something to him. Looks like the kid fancies the sword and is asking for it.
What sword?
A toy. Just a shiny toy sword. They were given.
Okay.
Okay. So our hero hands over the sword. He's holding on to the hilt, hand extended. The child is trying to take the sword but can't.
I see. And then what happens?
Then, nothing happens. It's the end of the recording. The explosion is coming up. Here's a grown-up approaching the kids. That's the transfer operator. He walks up to his patient and asks him something. The latter turns around and blows up a second later. And that's it. Doesn't clear up much, I'm afraid.
What was his name?
Mark. Or who are you asking about? The one who blew up? That was Albert.
And the other child?
The little one? Don't know. He was one of the locals.
Not sure how he ended up
inside the garden. Have fun with your little mystery now.
See you tomorrow?
I don't know. It might be 3-4 days, maybe a week. We'll see. All right, take care now.
Hold on, Tabaha. I've got one more question.
I told you everything I know about this garden. I got nothing else.
It's not about the garden. It's about my parents. I wanted to remember something about my parents.
Here.
Aha!
What's this?
A key.
Is that how I'm gonna get in?
Where
yes!
Bachin left it to me. He said that if ever you ask me about your parents, to give you this key. So,
bingo.
That's what I'm doing.
Goodbye, Tabaha.
I'm glad my annoyance led me to come out here first, because I would have wasted all that time otherwise. Alright, head on inside. Ah! Close the door since it's gonna rain. And bingo! Oh, right. Gotta actually use the key. Ta-da! Nice. Now. Flashlight attachment? Okay. Ah, the journal. Read all the entries, why not? He's dead, not like he's gonna care. Well, well, now the home of my son is empty, so fate has decided. I'm not complaining either. I don't know what voice this is. Providence knows best. All that's left for me is to pray for them.
I'll head out in the morning. It's over 200 miles. Better not forget a gas canister. It'll be dark when I get there. The wake will go on all night. Come morning, I'll be gone, leaving everything as is.
Well, I mean, Anabish doesn't sound Mongolian, so why should I? Alright, let's see. You guys can pause this if you really want to read it all. I'm just gonna skim my way through it. He won't drink milk, he won't eat anything. What do I feed him? He's growing so fast. Oh, he's talking about me. Early for a two-week-old child to walk on his own 2 feet. Can't figure out what he found. Some kind of advice. Weird. Huh. Wait, what? If these dates are correct, and it's month, day, year, and that's the same year, but a 5-year-old is... What? Huh. Where's Providence, you reckless... Wait, what? Anabish, if you're reading this letter, it means that curiosity has led you into the past to your forebears. Your parents' belongings are locked away in chests. I will give you the key with which to open them. But know this, no things will give you any answers until you've asked yourself the right question. Of all the possible paths, only one will lead you to this question. Find this one true path, and may my modest assistance ease your search. You need a ray of phantom light to illuminate your path, and a wise clue to make the right decision at a crossroads. In this drawer lies a rounded object. Use it to obtain the ray of light. In the Book of Wisdom you'll find a clue, then go to my graveyard, stand on the largest stone, and take a look around using the ray of light. Look carefully, and you will see the spot from which to begin your path. Okay, interesting. I knew his grave would have something to something. Well, passport, about Jindala. Okay. Receipt for a scooter tire. Where's the key? He said he'd give me the key. Which means I need the flashlight. Shablam! Alright, can we combine them? Ta-da! There we go. Alright, so head out over to Grandpa Batchin's grave, which is over here, right? There you go. Batchindala. Alright, so the biggest... Aha! Well, that was easy the second I pulled it out. Cool. Alright, just making sure there's nothing else there. Okay, so light... And a D. Some. Weird. Like, what kind of ink would you be able to leave there for that long? That's one, invisible. And two, doesn't just get washed away. I think I might have lost the path. Alright, retrace our steps. And find the clue again. Want to see... This would be good practice for seeing... where'd the... this stupid thing go? There it is. Okay. So if we're going to go in a straight line... See, it actually... Wow, it actually reflects rather strongly. Okay. Go in this direction. Ha! Go in this direction. Well, how I missed that one before. Going in a straight line, so I... I don't think think I've missed anything. Now, I would have... As often as you run into them, it wouldn't... I can walk that far. Maybe we should take the other path, see if we can find... Okay, so it was right here. Maybe try this one. Oh, there we go. Nope. Head back this direction. So let's keep going for the D then. That one seems to be getting us the results we need. Alright. D, head this way. I'm not really sure where I'm being led, but... Alright. The D! As long as it doesn't lead us to some guy with his pants off, I think we're okay. Okay, so this one points back towards the grave. Not seeing any. It's really not getting us anywhere whenever we go towards that sun. I think that might be part of. Let's see. Read the parable from the book Under the Altar. Whoops! Patchen's Graves. Not far from the year. Yeah, I missed a step. My bad! Wow! Dude's got some jumps! Pure white flame burns so brightly, so blindingly, pains the eye to behold it. Pure white flame. Pure white flame burns so brightly. Okay, does that have something to do with the reflection? No, I mean, it's going to... Oof. Pure white flame. Hmm. Oh. Let's head this way. Nope. That one actually lied to us, so... Basically, we're gonna have to alternate which one we're looking at to even see. Let's see, go this way. Where'd it go? Dang it. Nah, I was a little bit too off there. Okay, so head this way. Bingo. Head this way. Should be near these rocks. We'll keep walking. This is frustrating. I don't understand. Pure white flame. That's not really wise words. Unless it's got a code built into it. There it is. Whoops. Wait, what? Well, that's new. Didn't see that before. Huh. Wonder if that has anything to do with what I'm hunting. Probably not. Alright, so... The D is pointing back this way, towards the hut. Alright, let's follow the sun once again, see if we can't get something off of it. Pure white flame blinds. So blinding. It's so bright that it's blinding. Let's see. and clue from the parable to find the key to the chests. I want to say maybe I'm supposed to dig up, kind of like we did with Ida's bits and parts, that we dug it up from the ground, so maybe I'm supposed to kind of take a look around here to dig up something that is buried? I mean, imagine the key has got to be in like a box or something, maybe? So that it's protected, and it's not going to stick it in the freaking trees or anything, is he? Alright, tell you what, I'm going to tinker around once more. We'll see if we can't figure this stupid riddle. Alright, so I think I figured this out properly. Sun and the moon. We had the sun earlier, now it's the moon. Sun reflects off of the moon, so we'll start with the sun, and you just alternate, I think? Let's see. Okay, so we did the sun first, we'll do the moon this time. And you also have to be careful, you gotta shine your light around. Kind of take it slow and easy. Especially with stuff like this where it's hidden. Okay, we just did the moon, so we do the sun next. We do the moon after that. Well, it's holding up so far. Usually it's about 5 Mississippis between them. So we do the sun next. So if you screw it up, go back and then try. Right. Like that. If you screw it up, go back a step. If I can find it, there we go. Is the moon next? So we go moon. There's moon. Okay. Sun. Did I mess that up? Aha! I'm gonna do moon. Let me do sun. Good lord, this is all this for a key to a chest. I'm gonna do moon. Key to a chest you could just as easily break open. Good lord. Sun. Moon. That didn't take me anywhere. Alright, moon. Oh, there it is. Oh! Who am I? Oh, that's why that popped up. Who am I? Huh, is this the thing we already looked at before? Yeah, it is. All right, so here you'll find the answer. Who am I? Go figure. All right, you are about to step away from unraveling the mystery from the ancient mystifying events. Promised you a key to this. Belong to my parents. However, these people are not your parents. Oh, or even your relatives. They had a son of their own once, but he had died in that explosion under the dome. Ah! Shagatai. Several days later, after Golden Eagle. Really? Ungots was carrying me? Huh. Interesting. Home of late sun became a haven for you and Ungots. It's not repulsed by the strange appearance of your bodies. Who am I to pass judgment on Providence? Oh. Oh, so this is more and more interesting as things go on. Let's figure this out, though. Alright, had a little bit of a hiccup. But we're back. And let's let the secrets be revealed! What kind of secrets are these? A computer? Thing? Alright, let's go ahead and put this over here. Gently. Don't know what that's about. Maybe it has something to do with them bodies. A saddle? Do I get a horse? That'd be sweet. If I got an eagle and a freaking horse or something, it'd be sweet. Alright, so what else do we have in here? Looks like an old-timey radio. It is an old-timey radio. Can we put that... Oh, no! Well, we just made room, so go ahead and put that down. Crap. Foreign letters. Oh. Just accidentally hit the tip. Alright. Check the mags over there. Can we move this whole thing? Yes, we can. Eh. Alright. Now for the real reveal? Yeah. Maybe now we get some answers. Is this open? Nope. Guess it doesn't open. Yarn balls? This looks like we might need it. Let's stick it over. Eh.
What does it say? Hyper something? Hyper filter? Something like that.
Alright. Take the yarn, throw it in there. Boots. Very, very stylish boots. Was any of this... Oh? Pictures. Oh. Okay, let's stick the picture over here. Make it all homey and cozy. Get the boot out of here. Out! This is what we're looking for, maybe? Packs of letters. Mark and Ida have already written to you about a man who works nearby at the station. Says they saw each other only once in a company of friends. Go to Ida and... interesting. Alright, so what, a bunch of... Speak with Ida. So now I'm just chucking crap around for no reason. I'm making a mess. Oh well. Alright, lady, we got stuff to talk about. Cough it up.
I found it. You and Mark had met once before.
Yes, I already know. I remembered it.
Mark was recalling some kind of special moment.
Nothing so special that it stayed with me. Except maybe...
A sensation?
Yes. Sometimes I get a peculiar feeling. It somehow resembles anxiety, but only partially.
What, butterflies in your stomach?
I can't really describe it. It is a sad, pleasant feeling.
Nostalgia?
I had felt it again that particular evening, and...
Recollection of feelings?
What? Anabish, I'm about to shut down.
Wait. You're not done figuring out your past.
And we won't. I am out of time.
From whom?
From my neurochip. Only... The neurochip writes in red letters. I'm being informed that it is self-destructing.
Oh, dear.
Know what I can do?
What?
Split myself in two.
The what crap? Do you mean?
When I shut down, my upper half will split.
What?
Why?
I've no clue. That's just how my body works. I can show you. Watch.
So, what? She shuts down her bottom half and the upper half stays?
Wait, don't. Ida, listen.
I'm listening.
Maybe there's still a way to fix everything.
Fix everything? Well, there is a way. If you can travel to the past and pass 4 digits to Professor Koch.
What?
That would fix everything. Fix. Everything.
Uh-oh. Here comes the shutdown. Boom! Where's this whole split she was talking about? Oh! 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 And now it's raining. And this yurt apparently is not water sealed. And why would you put crap right in the- oh dear lord. Okay, so... now her head is coming apart? What the- can I stick that on you? Nope. Oh, this is morbid slash disturbing. Can I put you in my inventory? Shock with electricity to speak for a few minutes. Oh, I can stick her on the top maybe? Maybe I can get lightning to strike her body so we can talk. This is super disturbing. I'm kind of lost here. Alright, so we've got... I'll put her body down real quick. I need to see if there's a particular spot that lightning's striking. Powerful source of electricity. Looks this out of the back. Where's a... garden? Yes, the garden. Alright. Let's go, little lady. Must brave the storm. Why it's so important to figure out her past, I'm not sure. Other than perhaps it gives us some insight into our own past, but is it really worth going and possibly electrocuting the crap out of ourselves? I guess so. Let's find out. Go, 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 go. This just went 0 to 100 real quick. The heck? Loving the music all of a sudden. Hopefully none of those black cloud things screw with us. Alright. So we're here. How do we get up there? Vertical position at the center of a ruined flower bed. What? Which ruined flower bed? Here? Nope. What is that screaming? Oh! Ungots! Well, that's just morbid. What are you doing here, bud? You might not want to be attached to that for very long. We're gonna make an electric cable. What electric cable? Aha! That electric cable. Are we sure this is a good idea, considering I'm probably gonna get myself screwed up? Alright. Oh, good! Because this isn't a bad idea. See what I mean? What the crap just happened? I need to attach it to her plexus. Oh, I need to put it down before it lightning hits me. Got it. Her solar plexus? Okay. Lightning just struck. Let's stick it in. Wait, what? Oh, that bubble. Is the bubble deflecting us? What the crap's going on? Oh. That would probably help. Gah! Don't hold a cable when there's lightning. That's the moral of the story here, kids. There we go. Rather convenient that the storm just popped up out of nowhere. Seriously, Ungots, you might want to move. Jeez. That's why you don't look directly at something that could potentially explode.
Are you there?
Ida. Yeah.
I'm here.
How do you feel? Strained? In what way? Describe your state.
I feel anxious.
That's good.
Good?
Yes. Just don't shut down. Look at me.
Why?
I'll explain everything later.
Okay, now Anubis is getting creepy.
Wait, what? That's the end? That's the end. What? Alright, well, thanks for joining me, guys, in our fourth hour of, and apparently final hour of Cradle. That was an unexpected ending. Kind of left me with a few questions, but I'll let you guys mull all of that over. Thanks for joining me in this kind of experience of the Cradle game. Kind of a different pace of things for me, so very much enjoyed it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Very good music and pretty immersive environment. Kind of poked your brain a few times there, I hope. But anyways,
see you guys in the next one. Hopefully we can find something just as intriguing and enjoyable for our next little playthrough. Cheers, guys. You've got some blood on you.